Hey guys, it is Mike, aka
Hey, this is Chrissy from Against the Current, and you're watching My Man Mike.
It is Sunday, the 28th of July, 2019. Today, I'm heading to Yalc, the Young Adult Literature Convention. Last year and the year before, I did all 3 days. This year, unfortunately, I'm only able to do 1 day. I wasn't even going to do that, and then I just decided yesterday, what the heck, let's go. I'm going to try and not buy too many books because I still have books from last year that I haven't read. But I get to see bookish people. I potentially get to get some free books. I get to have a look around some books. I get to have a fun day in London. So why not? Let's go catch the early train to London. I've got about 3-4 trains to catch to get up there in time. It's a bit mad, but that's Sunday trains for you. Pokemon Go has a Team Rocket event at 4 p.m. They have had a countdown and they've said that at 4 p.m. local time, they're taking over every single Pokestop. I'll be in the book convention. I'm glad that's all they're doing, because if it had been something a bit more exciting, I would have been sad that I'm missing it, or I would have probably left Yalc. But just taking over every Pokestop, I'm not that bothered. They'll be around for a bit longer, I'm sure. Right, let's go catch a train. It's 9:45. I'm at the Kensington Olympia. Just got off the train. I am going to go over to Tesco's and get myself some food and some drink, and then go and queue up to go into Yalc. So it's 10 o'clock. I just got in. I came out of the lift and the first person I saw was the lovely Tasha, who has a booktube channel called Fairy Drugs. But she also does Twitch streams where she does art, which is fantastic. That was so lovely to see her straight away. Literally, I turned and I was like, Tasha. Yeah, that was lovely. Now, there's lots of bookstores. Let's have a look. I have been in Yalc for less than 20 minutes and already made one book purchase. Killer Tea by Robert Nukemz. Harry and Charlie are teenagers who meet at a time when gene editing technology is starting to explode. Now with a lab in the garage, anyone can beat cancer, enhance the brain to pass exams, or tweak a few genes for a permanent tan, perfect beach body. But in the wrong hands, gene editing is the most deadly weapon in history, spanning 10 years and asking profound and terrifying questions. It's an unsentimental love story, a tale of human resilience, most of all, love of our times. Saw it in Waterstones, sounded really good, and it was cheaper here, so why not? It's an hour in, I've bought 2 books, I'm being pretty restrained. I've entered a few competitions, but not tons. There is lots of raffles on, there is lots of people crowded around one stall, which to me makes me think they're doing a giveaway soon. There's lots of things to do at this. I've entered a few raffles. I think I'm going to go sit in a panel for a bit and just chill.
Okay, I can just put your hands. Rose Interrupted, Radish. Rose is 17, Mudder is 13, and up until 18 months ago, they'd been part of a really closed religious sect. They knew the rules, they knew everything that they should do, very gendered, and then when their parents split up, they come out into this wild world where they have no point of reference. So it's about how do you survive when you don't know the rules? How do you develop relationships when you don't know what you should be doing? And how much are you really in control of your life, or do you have to follow what your peers do?
Right, Right, so the first person I'd like to introduce is Temi O. Her debut novel is called Do You Dream of Terror 2? And it came out earlier this year, right? Then there's also Alistair Reynolds. He's a former space scientist and author of over a dozen sci-fi novels, including the young adult series Revenger and Shadow Captain. And he also wrote two short stories that were recently adapted on Netflix in a TV series called Love, Death, and Robots. Yes. And last but not least, Sasha Alsberg. She is the New York Times bestselling author, number one New York Times bestselling author, of the Zenith series, Andromeda series, and her books are called Zenith and Nexus. And she is also a YouTuber. And there's also me, I'm Tara Mathrew, and I'm the author of the Summoner series, which many people describe as a mix between Harry Potter, Lord of the Rings, and Pokemon. And I also have a new series out called the Contender series, which is kind of a cross between sci-fi and fantasy, and it's probably described best as The 100 meets Jurassic Park.
To be able to see sort of like a planet, but it's another thing to be sort of internally inside the character, understand that how it feels like how the planet is home, to live in their memories, and that's sort of the wonderful thing about all kinds of novels, is that you have this chance to live another life.
I think it's nice to kind of visualize for yourself what alien creatures look like. I've been blessed twice. With folks, you get to spend more time in the characters' heads, and you kind of get to create who the characters you are reading about, and kind of create who they are visually, because you know not everybody pictures characters the same way. So in science fiction, I know at least in my books, they have lots of cool features, like they're alien creatures and races, and it's super cool seeing how different people, especially my co-author, visualize them. Like for example, we picture our main character in two completely opposite ways. Don't know how that happened, but it happened, and you know, we kind of come to terms with how we picture her in the sense of fan cast. So do you guys know the lead character of The 100? Yeah, so that's how we picture her. And we pretty much have pictured every single character in our books as the 100 cast. So it's fun, and you get to spend more time in this world because, you know, with movies they can be a little bit more rushed, but in books you can take your time. And if you do it well, it'll take a lot of time. Serialized novel. We were going to release 6 parts separately, like 50 pages each. We only ever got to the first serialized part because then it hit the New York Times list and the publisher wanted to pick it up, and so we did that. But so we really crafted this whole story around this 50-page piece, and that we're very much not plotters or pantsers. We kind of had to evolve and change that for the second book. But Lindsay and I really just kind of built the two in unison and together as we were crafting the story because, you know, it is very plot-driven, but there are also lots of characters, so it must be character-driven as well. And it's so much fun getting to craft this world around this, like, band of, like, misfit, you know, space pirates who go on a rescue mission that goes awry, and, you know, we get to see, like, the colors of gray in play with who's evil, who's good. It's your choice as a reader to figure that out. But so, like, I think that when it comes to creating the world or creating the character first, it was really, they both came first in a weird, strange way. And it kind of helped me, the co-author. So one of you can focus on one of the elements a little bit more than the other, and then you can switch it around. So it sounds really messy because it is very messy. I love social media, so if I can kind of use my social media to then amplify my books, I will. And that's a huge reason why I love young adult. And fun fact, young adult didn't even have its own section in bookstores, so, you know, 10 years ago. So it's a fairly new thing, and I hope that new adult has its own section soon.
Yeah, I definitely noticed, like, I'm a huge fan of bricks and mortar stores, I must just go on the record. But, like, a real plus of, I guess, like, more people buying books online is that there's a different, I mean, there are certain people who just don't go to certain shelves. Like my mum, until I published a science fiction novel, had never been to the science fiction section of a bookstore. She was really like, this is a whole new world. And I think like the fact that a lot more people are buying their books online means that there isn't this sort of like really obvious demarcation between different genres.
How did it go? So it was
On the other side, I think, is my soul. Yeah, this is it. No, I've got it. So on the other side was my soul, because that was all about ghosts and what happens to your soul after you die, and sort of the unburdening of your soul of secrets. All that you can see was my mind, because it was all about like anxiety and depression and worry. It was all about the things that sort of I feel like my brain grapples with. And when the curtain falls was my heart, because it's the thing, it's theatre and writing, the things that I love so much. So I feel like now that I'm writing In Time We Lost, which is the next book, which comes out in October, it feels like this is the first time where it feels much more, it feels like the book that I'm writing as an author, as opposed to like putting myself, or putting, like laying down my soul for everyone to see, very separate. But I'm very lucky to work with very supportive people who are the first in line to buy the book. They're very, very sweet. Or they come to me and they're like, have you got any spare copies you've got lying around? So I try and keep it separate, but I just have wonderful friends who end up reading the book. And they tweet me their progress as well. They like text me their progress. Which is, it's always terrifying when you're on tour as well, because you'll like be on a train with them and they'll just be sat opposite you reading your book. And I'm just like,
the idea of watching someone read your book is
the
one of the worst things I can imagine.
It's the worst.
Well, I've just spent most of 2 hours in panels. First up, I got to see the sci-fi panel with Sasha Olsberg. Got to briefly speak to her afterwards, really, really briefly, but that was lovely. And then there's a panel with Carrie Hope Fletcher. And got to very briefly chat to her afterwards, and that was lovely too. Okay, so it's nearly 3 o'clock. I have seen one other book that I want, maybe, I don't know. I'm thinking about it. But at the moment, I'm just having a wander about. I think I'm actually going to head down to Comic-Con and have just a little wander around, because I haven't been down there yet. Come down to the con. Not going to vlog with any cosplayers, because I'm not here for the actual con, the Comic-Con rather, but there's a lot of cool cosplayers around. I'm now just having a wander, seeing what there is, and trying to resist buying any Pokemon collections rather than books. Let's have a wander and see what I can find. Around, it is absolutely boiling in the downstairs area. It's really warm and really overheated. I'm going to try and find the way back towards Yalc and then head down and go and get a drink in Tesco's. Okay, I've got my re-entry stamp. I've come out. I'm going to go to Tesco's, or I might go to another shop nearby, just, I think they're a bit cheaper, just to grab a drink. It was boiling inside and I ran out of things to drink. I'm going to keep hydrated. So also, in about 12 minutes there's an event in Pokemon Go where Team Rocket will be taking over every Pokestop. I'm so hot that the stamp that I got for re-entry is already fading. Yay! All the Pokestops, as you can see over here, have changed into Team Rocket stops. I changed my mind. I'm going to do a few and I'm going to film maybe one or two. I'm going to go do a Raichu raid, and alone in Raichu raid, just use today's pass first. I'm not going to film that. Hopefully I can get a shiny one. But if I do, I'll show you. If I don't, I won't. Yeah, I'm going to do that quickly. I'm still boiling, but it's nice out here. It's actually quite cool. So that's good. Yeah, time to cool down, do some raids, do some battles, and just enjoy a bit of fresh air, and then go back to Yalc. Did the raid, got a 96% non-shiny Alolan Raichu. I did about 4 grunt battles. 2 of them I failed badly. 2 of them I completed, which you've just seen. Now I'm going to head back into the convention. Well, some of the bookstores are actually doing sales now because it's the last sort of hour or so of Yalc. And I went to one that had a book that I've seen and it looked pretty good. Unfortunately, all the copies had gone. I guess on the plus side, that saves me some money. Right, it is 6:03. A lot of the stores are already closing up. I'm just going to have a quick look around, one more lap, and then I'm going to head home. Well, Yalc is over. I've left, and I only bought 2 books. I'm actually very impressed with that. There was a 3rd one that I wanted, as I said, but it sold out, so that's good. I only spent £10. I'm happy with that. Now to head to Victoria Station on the tube, so I'm going to get some food and then get the train home. Right, made it to Victoria, got some food, time to get on the train. Well guys, it's just gone 10 p.m. I've been back for about 30 minutes. Yalc was good this year. Going for one day was different. Although 3 days, I find, I don't know, I just got a little bit bored because it was all the same stalls, the same books being sold. Yeah, it was good. I enjoyed it. I purchased 2 books. First one is The Fandom Rising by Anna Day, which is the sequel to The Fandom by Anna Day, funnily enough. And I really enjoyed The Fandom. I've been waiting to get this one. And now I've got it. Which means at some point I'm going to read it. I also got Killer Tea by Robert Muchamore. I read the details about this to you earlier. I did see my friend Jenny and she did say this was quite a problematic book, so I was like, oh god. But I'll see what I think of it. I picked up a little sampler of a book called Imaginary Friend by Stephen Chbosky. I don't know. He was the author of The Perks of Being a Wallflower. Apart from that, I got a little sampler of the next Laura Stephen book. Little thing for this book, Rose Interrupted. I thought that was a sampler, but it was just a poster. The Book of Dust, Volume 2, The Secret Commonwealth. Just a little rail card holder. The next Book of Dust book is out on the 3rd of October. I'm reading the first one at the moment and I'm really enjoying it actually. It's taken a while, but I've only been reading it for probably about 3 or 4 days and I'm enjoying it. I just need to find more time to sit down and read. Yeah, that's all I got at Yalc. Didn't get much of a haul, didn't buy much. Yeah, it was fun. I got to see some cool panels. I got to see Sasha Allsberg, who wrote Zenith and Nexus. I got to see her panel. And then afterwards, as she was walking out, I got to briefly say hi to her. And I saw the lovely Carrie Hope Fletcher do a panel. And then I got to briefly say hi to her as well. Didn't get any photos with them, but they were going to their signings. So yeah, it was a cool day. Got to see a couple of people I know. Yeah. Not sure if I'll go back next year. I'm going to have to think about it. But I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, smash that like button. Leave me a comment below with what you've been up to this weekend, and I will see you with another video soon. Bye, guys.
Subscribe to Mike because he's fantastic.